anyway, we have As Tears Go By on this right now. And
because I'd like to learn how this works, of course, we just get out of this.
Okay, so what we do is we stop as tears go by and we zero it out. Okay? And then we go into menu right here. Push the menu button. It comes the jog wheel, you can move around for different functions. So we're working on a song. When we're ready to do our disc, we bring it over here to disc. This board is capable of so many things. I'm just scratching the surface on it now. So anyway, we want to pull up our song list. So we go to songs and we push yes. We have a yes enter and a no exit button right here. Batch of functions. One of them is create, which is what we would go to if we want to write a new song. And what you have to do is go into this device and write the title for the song before it'll give you the space on the hard disk to do so.
How does it compare to what people used to have to do to record music?
Ah, good question. This is one of the predecessors to this device sitting right over in the corner there. That is a four-channel cassette player. That Tascam came out with back in the early 70s. And actually, we're able to lay down four separate channels on that very thin eighth-inch tape. And the quality was marginal, but you could actually record four channels on it. Now, all of the Beatles, a lot of the Beatles material, the early stuff was done on a four-channel reel-to-reel. Which I'm going to try to bring one in to show you guys how that operates. Back in those days when they were using all this loud equipment, they had to put all of the equipment in a sound room because it had what they called electronic servos. Instead of pushing these little buttons, you'd push a button and it'd go click, push a button, the reels would go click. And you had to isolate that from any open microphones in the studio. So they would set up a control room and then have a sound room where the recording would take, where the musicians would do their work. Now that everything is basically silent, even the computer hard drives are very, very quiet, almost totally silent. They have an open control room like this. This is what we would call a project studio, because we can move things around in the studio to do different projects. And if we look here, we have our complete list of songs. Our songs, As Tears Go By, Beckology, and I've got to change the title of this one, which is Knocking on Heaven's Door.
Knocking on 7-Eleven's door, maybe?
This that sounds like a weird Al Yankovic song. Anyway, this recorder has three different partitions on its hard drive. Think of this as the hard drive disk. So it has three different partitions. Okay. That separate the disk. You can record up to 250 songs on each partition, which is just amazing. It's phenomenal what you can do with this equipment nowadays. Each song can also record 250 channels. So it's just amazing what it's capable of doing. Where the old cassette player, due to the fact that it ran at a higher speed, to capture a better frequency response, you can only get a maybe two to three songs on per cassette. So we want to go to Beckology. Now, when you're creating a song, there's a way to actually name the songs by running the jog wheel through the alphabet. We're in Beckology, and now what I do is I don't know if you've noticed this, I have put labels on masking tape along here. This one is,
can you say
Knocking on Heaven's Door. You can see it just behind there. There's the label for Beckology. I line it up with track number one, channel number one, right here, and lay it down. Don't have to press it real hard. And there's Beckology. We push the button to play it, and we should have Beckology. And we do. Now. Solo out channels. So if I just want to hear how that bass and drums are going, I shut off everything else and solo that channel. If I want to hear that rhythm, solo it, turn off everything else. You hear Alex's channel is on the right side. It's called a stereo split. So what we've done is we've panned Alex. Okay, so you go to pan fader here, lay down a phase guitar. Okay, you hear how that's sweeping? Hear that? The sound wave is sweeping. That's either a chorusing effect or a phase effect. So what we do is we will pan one rhythm guitar to the right, and we pan the other rhythm guitar to the left, and it gives it a stereo width. You hear how wide it sounds now? That is great. Like the beginning to 5.1 surround sound is the way it is delayed between speakers gives you the auditory effect of being in a large hall or a big theater.
Then you're all done. When you're all done editing, you just put a CD in and burn a copy, right?
Uh-huh.